Good evening, students. In continuation of our last topic, circular flow of income, we had begun with the four sectors in an economy, the four important sectors. Do you remember? Those were household sector, business sector, government sector, and rest of the world sector. Okay, now let us come to the main topic, circular flow of income. Okay, beginning of this topic we had already done in our last lecture, and I hope you must be knowing it. Circular flow. Circular means a continuous flow of income, you can say, between different sectors of an economy, or you can define it in another way, that is the flow of goods and services or factor services between different sectors of an economy. A circular flow of income comprises of three different phases. The first phase is production phase. During production phase, what happens that the producers, they hire factor services from household. It means they employ the workers. And from where the workers come? They come from the household sector. Okay, actually, it is only consumer that move to earn his livelihood. And for earning livelihood, we work under someone. It means we are providing our factor services to the producers. Okay, so what the producers do? They hire factor services from household, and they carry on the production of goods and services. This phase is also called production phase. Production phase means with the help of the workers from household, what they do? They do the production of goods and services. Now let us understand the process of value addition. Value addition means, suppose there is a producer A. Okay, and he has to produce this product BX. Okay, in order to produce this product BX, it has purchased raw materials of rupees 500. Okay, so what is the value of the raw material here? 500 rupees. Okay, now for producing goods and services, it has employed, for producing that good BX, it has employed the workers. The workers will start production. They'll use raw material to produce product BX. After applying all the raw materials and the process, it has produced the product BX of rupees 700. Okay. So, during this process of production, the raw material of worth 500 has been converted into another output of rupees 700. Okay. So, it means through the process of production, 500 have been converted to 700. So, how much rupees value is added? 200 rupees value is added. Right. So, what new worth has been created? A worth of rupees only 200 was created. Okay. This is called value addition. Now, again, we'll link to this example and we'll understand the concept of income or distribution phase, which is phase number 2. In this phase, income or distribution phase means the producers who have hired factor services from household, definitely if we are hiring some workers, we'll pay them for their work. Okay. But now the thing is that how much pay we'll be paying to them? Or definitely that payment will be in terms of the worth of their efforts only. That is according to the term of value addition. Just see here. All those workers, this producer has converted 500 rupees raw material into a product of 700 rupees. So the value addition is 200. It means how much effort this producer and his employers have made. Employees have made 200 rupees worth they have made. Okay. So these rupees of 200, which is equal to the value addition, will be distributed to the factors of production in different forms, like in terms of rent, in terms of salaries, wages, interest, etc. So what has been done? As much value addition is done, that equivalent amount of money is distributed to the factors of production. So now households or the employees, they have got income. Now what will they do? They'll use that income for satisfying their wants. It means they'll be consuming goods and services. They'll be buying goods and services. Hence, they will move to the third phase of circular flow of income, that is called expenditure or disposition phase. Okay. इसका मतलब वो क्या कर रहे हैं? They are only converting their income into a mean of satisfying their wants. So what they'll do? They'll purchase goods and services, and the expenditure which we do for consuming goods and services is called consumption expenditure. Okay, and do you think that they are only consumers who spend their income for consuming goods and services? There are some other sort of expenditure also, which is done by the producers. Like producers, out of their profit, what they do? They buy some machineries. That is also an expenditure, but it is called investment expenditure. Okay, so producers also buy goods and goods, final goods. This expenditure is called investment expenditure. So, what will happen? When they'll spend amount of money for goods and services, it will create demand. Okay, more demand will be created. Then what will happen? Ultimately, whatever expenditure we'll do, that money income will go to the producers again. Okay, because of our expenditure, more demand will be created. Motivated by that more demand, producers will produce more. Then more income generation, then more income expenditure, more demand. Ultimately, the cycle continues and it goes on continuously. It never ends, because we know that human wants are totally unsatiable. Why? Because as soon as one demand is satisfied, the another demand emerges out. So this is the circular flow of income, in which these three phases continuously operate, and the income or money, it continuously flows from production phase to income phase. It means the money is moving from producers to the household sector. Then household sector will obtain income, then they will spend that income for satisfying their wants, then again that income will go to the producers, and this way it goes on. This is the circular flow of income. I hope you would have understood it. Thank you.